Hey, Daniel, I'm gonna get you.
I bet you cannot
hit me. I can too. Whoa, it's a robot kid. What? It's a robot kid.
How you calling
me?
My robot legs
will get tired. It's a robot kid. Where are you going, robot? Where are you going?
Hey, guys, we made a cool video. That's right. Today, we're going to be taking a look at Wonder Dynamics Wonder Studio. It's a cool little program, an AI tool that automatically animates, lights, and composes CG characters into live action scenes. So ever since Corridor made a video with the software a few months ago, I've been looking into it and been hoping to play with it. This system pretty much does everything by itself. You don't have to have much skills at all. Of course, if you do have skills with Blender, mocap, or any of those things, you're going to be able to use the software at a more advanced level and tweak your outputs, which is pretty cool. And I'll even show you a little bit about that here in this video.
Hey, robot kid, we need to go to the store. Is that okay?
Yes, please.
All right, let's go pick out some cool robot stuff.
And rule the world.
Scrolling up to the top, you can see you've got a basic outline here of the website. You can log in, sign up, and you don't even have to have a credit card to sign up. That's pretty cool. This video is not sponsored, by the way. And what it is it's a VFX studio in your browser. And I can certainly personally attain to the fact that it's very easy to use and very robust, which I think is very cool. Let's take a look at this video.
They say all great stories start with a sense of wonder. And what if bringing those stories to life wasn't limited by our resources, but only by our imagination? Welcome to Wonder Studio.
He's learning.
Where making movies with CGI is as simple as selecting your actor
and
designing a character.
It's drag and drop.
The system uses AI to track the actor's performance across cuts and automatically animates, lights, and composes the CG character directly into the scene.
Okay, so here's a quick overview of the light plan that I have right here. And as you can see, it's quite a lot of stuff that you can, you know, play with right there, or at least they've got a lot of things listed there. Unfortunately, there's only 150 seconds of processed video that you can use. So if there's any type of the video or any part of the video that you're going to be submitting that doesn't have the actors in it, you don't want to put that in there. Basically, you're going to want to cut around the actors to make sure that you use the most of your processing time, and that way you don't have to spend more money to get larger and larger accounts or multiple accounts. So a couple of the features that you're going to see right away is that they have some characters that you can just drag and drop that are pre-built. You've also got a couple different scenes if you want to play around with theirs that are up here on the top. For example, the Dune is actually just two friends leisurely chatting and strolling down a street in Austin, Texas. And what they've done here is they've just put it through Blender to then put it with a different background and added some sand, looks like there. And with these different scenes, you can actually just play around with them, add them to your project. But for the most part, you're going to want to use your own scenes. And to do that, let's take a look.
No fire, please.
No, yeah, so we need to put some gas in you. Can you spin around real quick so I can see where your gas tank is?
Okay.
Wait, where's the gas tank at?
Here, where do I, right here, under my shirt.
Okay, so when we create new project, we have a couple of options here. We have the live action easy, which I have in the light plan, and then live action advanced, which is going to be more advanced to do without Blender, and that's something you're gonna have to pay more for. For me, I'm gonna just click continue here, and then what we're gonna do is we're gonna upload our video. Okay, so it's pretty easy to use here. Since I already used this videos for a project, I'm gonna just take and drag and drop a video into my project, and it's just uploads right into there. Once you do that, you have a simple editor here where you can go around and trim if you want to. I'm just going to go ahead and click next up here at the top so I can actually select my actor. What you want to do is you want to get to any frame that has the actor that you want to then show or swap out for a CG character. All right, scan frame for actors. There we go. And once it scans the frame, it's going to look for any of the people that it can find in there, and it's going to allow you to select them. And literally, you can just drag and drop a different CG character right there onto it. You'll notice up in the top left in the project, it'll show you the actor and the, of course, the character that you're using for it. If you want to use any of the CG characters that are already preset, they're just right here listed. If you want to add your own, you'll go up here and click the create character. You can add up to 6 characters in the light plan, and then you'll create the name for the character, add it in there, and then of course all the different assets that are necessary for that, which is a whole other video for a whole other time. You want to make sure you don't make the mistake of doing this, which is once it finds the actor, you don't want to drag and drop another one, because if you do that, you'll notice over here it's going to create a second actor, and that's not what you want. It might create some mishaps. So you're going to want to just go ahead and click where it says unassigned and just select actor one. You've already got it over here. The reason that you're going to want to possibly do that is if you have the actor going in between different objects, or if they change appearance at all in different scenes, you're going to want to make sure to find them, especially if you have cuts in that different video. If it's one video where there are no cuts, then you're probably probably not going to have to do it more than once. It's a pretty smart system. So let's go ahead and take a look at some of the results. Oh, but before we do that, when you click render to render the final composition, your choices are, of course, 720, 1080, and 4K. And you have different formats here that are available with your different plans. With my plan, I'm allowed to have the mocap, the clean plate, and the blender scene. But things like the alpha masks or even just a higher quality, you're going to want to need that larger plan to get those. Okay, so just like at the beginning of this video, I'm going to show you the rest of the scene that I created with Daniel, and then I'm going to show you guys a little bit of the behind the scenes on how we created that. This robot kid sure needs to look out for cars.
Let's take over the world together. Beep boop, beep banana boop. Ha ha ha. I want to say hi to my friends. Hang in there, guys.
Hey, robot kid, you can eat anything you want, okay? Yeah.
I'm the king of the robot world. Zoom, zoom, zoom.
No toys, robot. No toys. Freeze. And dance off. Okay, Daniel, I'm gonna see if the thing will boop you, so see if it'll work.
You won't have enough money.
Ha ha ha. Okay, so we had a lot of fun making that video, and we didn't have any storyboard or any real plan. We just knew that we were going to turn him into a robot, so we just pulled out the cell phone and just started randomly recording scenes on our way to the store to get some groceries and came up with this fun little video. Of course, with more time, with more effort, you can create some really amazing things, and I know that there's creative storytellers out there that are going to just blow our minds with some of the things that are going to happen here in the near future. So here is my output data. I've got the mocap data right here, which comes in different folders, and of course, these are the animation files that are going to go with each one of these. And with that, we also have the blender scenes, which I have in the background right here that you can see. And then not only do we have the blender scenes, but we also have the clean plates. So if you want to go ahead and throw on the backgrounds, the clean plates are, of course, going to be all the spots where the character used to be and no longer is. So you can see my son used to be in this video, and all of a sudden it is now a ghost video. There is no more kid in the video, just a blurred spot where he used to be. And that, of course, is where we're going to be able to use this animation in this file that we have behind us. So what I've done is I've just taken one of the Blender scenes here and I've opened them up in to Blender, just double-clicking it. And when you first open it up, you're going to basically get this simple, either a wireframe or this composite of your character. And with that, you can make it, you know, run around. Hey, cool. You can see the whole animation of him running through the yard in 3D space, which is really cool. You can do a lot of things with that by changing the background, changing your scenery. You can go in there and change the hands, the fingers, and all those little details to make it perfect. But not only that, if you're using one of the Wonder Studio characters, you can actually go to their website here. They have all the character textures available to you. You just click on the one that you're using. For example, I was using this tech head, so I downloaded the textures right there, and there's a little how-to. All we had to do was go into the external data, click on Find Missing Files, and then put ourselves into the directory where we had the missing files, which was RoboKid and textures. So we'll hit finding missing files with that. And then once we do that, it finds the files for you. My hard drive, my graphics card doesn't like it. I can see behind him. I can see what it looks like to be behind you now.
That's so weird.
Yeah, I can watch it from any angle.
That's so weird.
Uh-huh. So here you can see the attention to detail, and it's really incredible what they've actually got on some of these texture assets. And from here, you can also make manipulations and changes. So if you wanted to change any of that texture set, you can do that easily. If you want to change the actual video on the screen, it's also very easy to do that. Monitor screen. Oh, there's the monitor screens. Go in there and edit those. Or you got the video right there for the monitor. As I was editing the video, you'll notice there's some mishaps, like when he goes behind the truck, he doesn't quite get cut off, and as we're going in the seat, I noticed that as you're using the software, it's really great at tracking the character, but it doesn't understand when there's objects in front of the character, so you're gonna have to do a lot of masking if you want to put objects in front of the CG character that, you know, basically were there originally. If you want to add them in post, it's probably the better thing to do. So I tried a couple different scenes, like this scene right here. I knew that I was probably not gonna get this to work, so I wanted to record another one, because after I recorded that, I thought, hey, I probably should not have that as close to him. So this time you'll notice I kept it away from him just because I was thinking about that at the time. And luckily I thought, otherwise I probably wouldn't be able to use that scene. I didn't want to do that much masking the entire time. I found this interesting site called Narakeet, and it allows you to do text to audio. From here, I was able to click on the British, and with that, I could do Robo Voice or Child Droid. And with Child Droid, I was able to write in whatever text I wanted to, hit create audio, and that was how I was able to make his robot voice for the video. All right, and before we go, we're gonna take a look at the behind the scenes in the editor of Sony Vegas. This is what it looked like when I was putting it all together, and you can see some of the scenes. At any point in time, I'm able to, you know, kind of zoom in and do different things, but if I put up the top here, you can see what the original video would have looked like before I did the edits. So I'll go ahead and actually do an unlisted video where I show kind of the before and the after, just side by side. So if you guys want to take a look at any of the before and after footage, take a look in the description below. Also, if you're into Wonder Dynamics, this is just really amazing software. And you know, I haven't played with something that was so easy. Unfortunately for a lot of these people that spent years and years of their life learning how to do some of these things, we can see how software is slowly starting to take over. And that's okay, because it's going to allow for more opportunities for creativity in other ways and other paths. And these tools have always, since the beginning of time, since we had computers, been advancing in ways that we can't quite foresee. And this was one that I didn't see happening as soon as it happened or as quickly as it was going to happen. But of course, with the advancements of AI, really nothing should surprise me at this point. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And if anything, it's going to give you some insight on what's possible with today's technology. Be careful with what you look out there. Not everything is going to be real anymore. And of course, if you want to make some fun videos with your friends or family, this is a very unique and cool way to do it for the time being. So I enjoyed making the video, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Stay tuned.